Welcome to the Mean Workshop. I hope you've enjoyed the series of lecture on Node, Express, MongoDB, and Angular. Now it's time to build the project. In this project, you will be building a RESTful API and an Angular UI layer with the full stack generator to facilitate the list of accounts and the simple CRUD. The form that you see on your screen is to add a new account. Under it, you will see the list of existing accounts with the delete button for each account. Before we proceed, I will show you the live demo of this application. Before we can run the application, we want to launch our MongoDB database with the MongoD command. And it says waiting for connection on port 27017, which is good. Now I'm going into a new window. I need to keep the Mongo database window running. And this folder, it's inside of the MEANWorks repository. It's in the app folder, all this code. And once I'm inside of this folder, I can do npm start, which will output me a message, Express server listening on port 9000. So we can go to the browser and navigate to that port. Once you open this page in your browser, localhost colon 9000, you would see the header, online banking, which I changed from the default header, which Angular full stack generator had, ng full stack new, that's the name of the app. And if I go to slash accounts, I can enter any information here and it will be propagated to the server. It says new account and I refresh the page on the post just to show you how it works. Then I can delete this account. Now let me refresh it. So the message is gone. I'm going to transactions. In this case, I would not refresh the whole page on the on-click event for the dispute. I will let Angular update the view. So now, this in fact updated the database as well, because if I refresh the page, I see that the change didn't move back to the dispute. It remained at the cancel. So I'm using icons from the Twitter Bootstrap class, and the table is also from the Twitter Bootstrap. So this is a short demo for the application that you will be building. Okay, so now create a new folder. I recommend you using name app, but it doesn't really matter. And then I assume you already installed the Yeoman generator and the generator Angular full stack. Then you can use this command, yo angular-fullstack space ng-fullstack-new. So Angular full stack, that's the name of our generator. Yo, it's a Yeoman command. And ng full stack new, that's the name of the application. Of course, you can pick a different name, but I recommend you stick with this name. Why? Because our tests will verify for the existence of this name. So it's useful to keep the name the same. And then you can run some tests and grant serve will spin up the Express server. And you can go to localhost port 9000 to see the result of your command. You can also use npm space start, as you've seen in my demo. So what that command actually generated? We have node modules, we have E2E folder, which is for end-to-end tests. And by the way, node modules, that's for npm modules. Yeoman would also execute npm install to download the required modules for you. So most of the cases you don't need that. And then server will have our node and Mongo and Mongoose and Express files. Client will have Angular.js files, controllers and templates. And then package.json is our metadata for the project, npm shrink wrap will have the nested versions. Index.js, it's the main entry point for the application. That's how we boot it up. Readme.md, just the basic information. And then transactions.json and accounts.json. Those files would not be generated by your command, but you can find them in the repository for the MEANWorks. You will need these files to seed your database. Okay, so the local setup. You need to have Node, NPM, Mongo, and Git, obviously. To install them, you could execute this command. If you haven't done that already. And then, as I mentioned, your Angular full stack will create a new project. It would not create a new folder, so you need to cd or navigate into that folder. These are commands how we can create some endpoints, which is a server-side code. Angular full stack endpoints and then the account. We would also need a route, which is a client code for accounts. Client means Angular and server means Express and Node. And do the same for transaction and transactions. So an interesting thing here is that endpoint will take singular, but the route takes plural. Most of it because the endpoint on the server will create multiple endpoints, and they will all share the same noun, which also called resource. And the route is usually plural. That's what you see in your URL. Okay, so grant test will test existing endpoints and routes after you generated them with your commands. Let's take a look at the Express app. We can see there are some middleware like error handler, body parser, and course, which is cross-origin resource sharing. The MongoDB connection is created as well, and it already has this database and gfullstacknew-dev. You can have multiple environments. Now we can take a look at this route app.get. So this is a server-side code. This endpoint will be responsible for getting the transactions. And all it's really doing, it takes this transactions collection and executing a find. And then we convert that database cursor to an array and send it back to the client. This is how the server is starting up, app.listen. We can also start the server manually by using nodemon. I've put it in the MEANWorks, so you can use nodemon. Why nodemon is better? Because it will restart our server-side code, our Express app, every time we make changes to the index.js. Okay, so now we have some time to see the database with accounts and transactions. You can just copy-paste these commands and they would populate the database. You can see that the name of the database, it's the name of our application, -dev, and then I'm passing the name of the collection. And also, by default, Mongo imports works only with one object. So it will complain to you if this file has an array of objects. So we need to pass an option, JSON array. This way we can insert multiple records from an array, which is in files transactions.json and accounts.json. Feel free to copy the files from my GitHub, MEANWorks. Once you're inside of Mongo shell, and once you seeded the database, it's a good idea to double check that the records are actually there. You can do that with db.transaction.find. And then run the app and go to accounts. probably you would not see anything because we need to add something extra to our Angular code. This is how our route will look like. So it has a URL accounts, and it tells us that it loads templates from accounts.html and the name of the controller. That's a good information. So we can actually go to that controller and add this service. $http.get will get the list of accounts, and we use promises.success callback will put the result of accounts into the scope. This is the exact reason how we can get accounts in our template. So in templates, we will use directives. Directive is just a fancy name for the special language that Angular uses in templates. Let's take a look at ng-repeat. It's one of the directives. We say account in accounts, and remember accounts now it's a scope variable, so we can we will get access to that array, and it's coming from the server. And account singular, that's each individual account in that array. So we can output using curly braces a name and a number, which are properties on the account. ng-if is another directive. If it's true, that element will be shown. If it's false, it would not be shown. So I'm using dispute double equals false. So if dispute is true, then this link would not be shown. If it's false, then it would be equal. False is equal false, then it will be shown. And then I also have ng-click, which is executing a function, dispute transaction, which I will define on the controller. ng-hide is hiding a particular element. And I'm using glyph icons from Twitter Bootstrap to add styles. So I'm checking that the date is pending. If date is pending, I will show a question mark. So this is another ng-click. This is for the delete button. All I'm doing is passing a function name, remove action, and then I'm also passing account because I want to know what is the ID so I can send that ID to the delete endpoint. You can look up other icons at glyphicons.com. If you have any questions, send me an email. If you have any bugs, open the GitHub repo issue. These are the steps in the workshop. Go from top to bottom. The first three, they really deal with the installation of MongoDB, Node, and other dependencies. Then you would create a folder, seed the database, create endpoints, and work on UI. To install the workshop, all you need to do is clone the GitHub repo, cd into the folder, execute npm install, wait a little bit, especially if you're using npm 3, and then link it to your command line. If you prefer not to link it, instead of MEANWorks to launch the tool, you would need to execute node space MEANWorks in this folder. These are some of the commands for the MEANWorks. You can verify to verify the solution. You can ask for help. If you have a specific program name, you would pass it to verify as well. You can look up the official solution with MEANWorks solution, and sometimes you can skip a step with verify skip. Again, this is the list of the steps. Okay, so now it's your turn. Go ahead, install the tool. Do the each step one at a time after reading the instructions and hints. And have fun. As I said, any feedback, send me an email. If you have bugs, create a pull request, create an issue, go to MEANWorks. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your interest in the MEAN stack. Now it's your workshop time. Node MEANWorks.